Hey boys and girls, today is kind of an eventful day, and that's why we're going to be doing this short video. It's not that I feel vindictive or something like that, but every once in a while I have to justify things that I've said, and today is one of those days. So President Biden has decided that he's going to follow what I used to say about when the 50% point is for EVs. I think that the race is on, and I think that we need to get as fast as we can to an EV 51% to 49% ICE. I think the manufacturing takeover is not so far down the road, and I can basically tell you what my prediction is. Again, I believe in 10 years you're going to look at 49% of the products that are built are going to be ICE. And EVs and HVs, I think they're going to be 51%.
I think that I published this all over the place, so I'm going to stick with 2030. But that's where the crossover point is going to be.
Come on, you made news at 28, so we're not going to change that. It's going to be 28. But, backslide.
Don't back up? Oh, okay. No. All right, 28. But anyway, I think that's the time when more than 50% of the automobiles sold, will be EVs.
Later on today, he's going to be addressing the UAW and the automakers here in North America and saying that the 50% crossover point has to be in 2030. Now, I said that in 2019, and I said it again in 2020, and then in 2021, I said, I think I'm going to have to move it up. It's going to have to be 2028. I'm going to tell you right now, boys and girls, 2028 is going to have to be the correct number. Otherwise, there won't be an OEM in North America because the rest of the world is moving much, much faster than we are here. So, regardless of whether you're a Democrat or a Republican or an independent or whatever, that news coming out of the president is going to affect a lot of folks. A lot of folks that were sleeping or laughing, and you'll see little clips on how people reacted when I did say 2030 and 2028, you'll see a few people laughing, but I will tell you that people stopped reporting on me. They claimed it was because I was a micro influencer or some damn thing, but in actuality it was because of the radical change that would have to happen in order for us to get into 50% EVs in a really short period of time. So I think that this is a good move for the United States. It may not be wonderfully accepted by the Luddites on the planet, but if we don't move quickly, we will lose tremendously to the Chinese and especially to the Europeans. They are definitely on the move. So have a look. We'll show you a couple of clips. But remember, you heard it here first. I will give you the real predictions. I don't care what analysts say. I don't care what Bloomberg or Wall Street Journal or Financial Post or whomever. I think they get their information from maybe one of those old eight balls or something. But I'm telling you what, you watch what I have to say and I guarantee you it'll come true. So thanks for watching. And I'd like to thank the president for stepping up to the plate to try and save the automotive companies here in the United States. Thank you.